What's going on, guys? So today, as you read in the title, of course, I don't know why I even tell you what the video is going to be. I mean, you see it in the title, but anyway, today's video is going to be about gold. I finally purchased some gold after a very, very long time. You guys know I'm a huge silver bug. I love my silver. It's very obtainable. You can physically get a lot of silver for little money. Obviously, it's more expensive now than it has been in previous years. It's been really hanging around $26 an ounce for a while now. I almost want to say since the pandemic, you know, kind of hit, that $26, $25, $26, in and around there has been where it's lingered for a long time. And it's been pretty stable. And gold is in the $1,700 to $1,800 range, same thing. It's been pretty stable, even though obviously it goes up and down constantly. That's about the range it's been in. And as much as I love my silver, I really wanted to do a 180 on precious metals, and I wanted to get into gold. Now, in hindsight, I really wish that I got into palladium and platinum, specifically palladium. I don't think anyone predicted what was going to happen with that. That is insane, and that's probably why you see the news stories of everyone stealing catalytic converters, because if you don't know, it has platinum and palladium in it, all right? So that's sometimes why they steal them. They're very expensive parts, and they just bolt off your car, so it can crawl underneath there with a wrench set and just take it without having to bust into your car. So that's kind of a thing that's been going around. So just kind of keep an eye out if you live in a shady area. Gold. I wanted gold in the worst way. All right. I just really wanted to have like a nice chunk of gold. Like I've had like incremental gold. I got like a gram here and a gram there and a half gram. And I think I have 2 1/10 ounce coins. And that's cool and everything, but I wanted like a big chunk of gold. My part of my bucket list thing was to have a 1 ounce gold coin. And that will happen. I don't know. It might happen 10 years from now. It might happen next year. I don't really know, but I will save and I will absolutely get that. In fact, now I have kind of the gold bug. You know, I'll always have the silver bug. I'll always accept silver in trades. If you guys do trades with me for knives and gear and stuff, offer silver. You have my attention. I will always accept silver for trade stuff. And that's how I obtain a lot of my silver. I don't buy a lot of silver, especially at these prices. I'm comfortable buying silver like under $20 an ounce. I want to say like $16 to $18 is a sweet spot for me. I don't know when we're going to see $16 silver again, to be honest. In fact, I think my last precious metals video, when I talked about gold, I said I wanted to buy gold when it went down, you know, to 1,000. And people laughed at me. And I honestly have to get on board at this point and say, I don't know if it ever will. It might not go back to $1,000 an ounce in our lifetime. That's very possible. I mean, you never really know what's going to happen in the future. No one does. But I really don't see it going that low. It maybe get lucky. It goes down to 1,500 an ounce, a troy ounce. But who knows? I don't know. I was very, very comfortable in buying this gold at the current price of 1,700 and something. I think it was like 1,765. I don't know exact number. I write those stuff down for reference for myself, but I didn't look it up before I turned the camera on here. Now, of course, for coins, you pay a premium. So you're not paying just the gold spot price, what the actual value of the gold is. You're paying for, in this case, the Canadian Mint to make the coin for you. Right. And then, of course, the dealer has to get a little something, a little kickback as well for selling it. So let's actually look at the thing. Right. I mean, you don't want to stare at it through a bag. I just want to show you. I had decided to go through JM Bullion. There's a ton of great dealers out there. Atmax is the biggest. Everyone knows about Atmax. They have the most variety and usually the most stuff in stock. Right now, precious metals are hard to keep in stock. It's kind of like guns and ammo. You just don't see the variety that you used to see because guess what? People are buying it. They're buying it everywhere. But Atmax is not super competitive with the prices. You're going to pay more going through Atmax. You just have more variety of stuff to pick from. JM Bullion was always on my radar because they had better prices. They beat a lot of people's prices, not everyone's. And I'm sure there's websites I don't even know about that maybe there's even a better deal. Who knows? In fact, if you guys are into your precious metals, I mean, most of you guys don't want to share your sources because then other people get it, you know, and it drives the price and demand up and everything. But if you want to be nice and you want to tell everyone where you buy your, you know, silver and gold and palladium and platinum, let everyone know down in the comment section. You know, the more places, the better. But JM Bullion, they had an awesome price. I couldn't pass it up. It was the best deal that I could find on the internet at the time that I wanted to buy it. It's that simple. So I, you know, shopped around, searched around, and this is what I found. So, Yeah, I just want to show you, it came in a box. The box was discreet. The box return address didn't say anything that would remotely say there's gold in here. Okay, this is close to a $1,000 coin. And you wouldn't know that by looking at the little box it came in. However, interestingly enough, if you guys track your mail through the Postal Service, they have their informed delivery. I don't know if you know that, but you can sign up and you can see what's supposed to come in your mail before it gets there, like a day or two before or whatever. It'll say like, okay, this package is coming soon. Or they actually scan your letters so you can see what letters, what bills and stuff are coming like the day before. So pretty interesting if you didn't know that. Informed delivery, Google it. You can check out your mail before it gets there. But that tracking said something precious. It didn't say JM Bullion. It said something else, precious metals. And I was kind of like, oh man, I don't know. Does the box say that? I was like a little concerned. That's just a, you know, random thing I figured I'd share with you. But the actual box didn't say anything. So if you're a postal service person, man, woman, whoever it may be, if they got sticky fingers, they might not want to take that one. You know what I'm saying? And I hate to say it, but it's just something. It's like not all cops are bad, but there's a couple out there. Not so good. I'm sure the same thing applies to the Postal Service. A couple postal people just, I don't think I'm taking this home today. It happens. You know what I'm saying? It happens everywhere. Every profession, there's good people and bad people. So you want to make sure that your stuff's discreet so it doesn't walk away. Now, I don't know the process, but JM Bullion does insure older packages. So if this did go missing, if someone stole it along the way, even if it just got left there, I mean, I had a sign for this, but, you know, let's say it did get left somewhere, you know, I'm sure you're covered some way. You could look into that if you feel a little bit weird about ordering online. People always suggest go to local coin shops. In fact, most people will tell you that some of the best prices are in person at local coin shops. I live in the woods. I'm sure a lot of you know that by now. There are no local coin shops. The nearest one is probably an hour away. Is it worth going there? Yeah, probably, but at the time I just wanted to order it. So, no problems with shipping. That's kind of my point here. I was very comfortable using JM Bullion. I've used them before for silver. So I had a cardboard box, then it was bubble wrap inside, and then this was wrapped in its own piece of bubble wrap like this. Then we have this bag. Then inside the bag was this flip. The flip is basically, you know, these generic plastic ones. You could put like two larger coins in here, whatever you want. This was shut, and then we have security tape. I love this security tape, by the way. You know, if you guys know where to get, I mean, you could probably find this from Uline. I know Uline does a ton of different types of, you know, shipping stuff. But this security tape has like nylon strings in it. So you can't tear it. You just cannot tear it. It's impossible. And even when you try to peel it off, you can't really get the whole piece. It kind of like falls apart and stuff. So it basically lets you know, hey, someone tampered with this. So, I mean, you could cut it very easily. It cuts. It's just string. But as far as like, you know, it accidentally opening, like peeling open, it's not going to happen. It's impossible. Well, I shouldn't say impossible, but very unlikely. So that was secured. And then when you open the flip, all right, this one says varied because I got a better deal on buying a random year. This is often the case with gold coins. You could pick a specific year if you're a collector. Let's say you want to get, I don't know, a Cougarand from every year or something like that. You could specifically pick out years, but usually they're just a touch more. I didn't care. I don't care what year it was from. So I got the varied option to save a little money. And then the actual coin is like vacuum packed in this piece of plastic. Now I have to assume, I mean, this is made from the Canadian Mint, the Royal Canadian Mint. And I'm guessing, I don't know for sure, but I'm guessing that when they make these coins, they put them in a big sheet like this and they vacuum pack, who knows, 10 in a row, a sheet of 20. I don't really know, but that's probably how they send them to dealers. And then dealers cut them up probably for sale. So this was never touched by human hands, and it will never be touched by bare human hands. Obviously, any kind of collectible coins, because even though this will retain its value as gold, no matter what, you can eat it, crap it out, it's still worth the price of gold. Okay, no matter what. But as a coin, as a collectible coin, you don't want the oils from your fingers touching it. You don't want anything touching it. You want to really do that. Like when I open this, because I am going to get I have some coin, you know, capsules coming in the mail. Because I don't like them like this. I want a nice coin capsule. Just make storage easier too, because I plan on getting more down the road. Probably for the rest of my life. I'll buy gold and silver for the rest of my life, right? So I want to accumulate a little collection and display them and store them, you know, differently. But you want to wear, ideally, like those cotton gloves. I don't like those things. I don't even have them. I did look online. You can use latex but or rubber gloves, but I think they say to use nitrile if you can, because some of the latex is powdered. You have to make sure you don't use the powdered gloves because then the powder gets on the coin. It's a whole thing. But when the time comes, I'll make sure I think I do have latex gloves that are not powdered, excuse me. So anyway, after all this, you're like, dude, just what's the coin look like? That's all I care about. I'm going to move on and watch my other videos for the day. So here we go. Here's the coin. I'm sorry. I talk. You guys know that. I talk and talk. So this coin is a Canadian maple leaf. Now, there's a bunch of gold coins to choose from. And by the way, if you didn't already see it, this is a half ounce. I didn't get my full ounce. And that's just because I didn't wait long enough. I wanted to buy it now while the prices are where they were. I've been saving for years, by the way. I have a change jug and I have a separate thing that I save money occasionally. Like if I go to the store and I spend 20 bucks on something and I get $4 back in change, I put that aside. I save that. That's my forced savings. I pretend like it doesn't exist. And that savings eventually accumulated to $1,000. And when it got to $1,000 recently, after who knows, 2 years or 3 years, whatever it was, I decided to invest in gold with that money. And as much as I would have loved a full ounce coin, that's almost twice, because obviously this is half the size. So I got a 1/2 ounce Canadian maple leaf. So you can see this is 9999 fine, four nines. Now, this was originally the purest gold coin on the planet. Most gold, like precious metals, is three nines. Right? 999 fine. What that means is it's 99.9%. The Canadians said, not good enough. We're going to make it 99.99% pure gold. Now, the American Eagle, this is interesting. This is all interesting stuff if you're into coins and obviously gold and all that. But the American Eagle, I think, is 91.67% actual pure gold. And they also put in copper and silver, and that is for strength, okay? That is so that it's not so soft. Pure gold like this, in its purest form, is soft. If you were to drop this coin, it could dent. It could scratch extremely easily. So the idea of having an even purer gold is great for the collectors. It's just a cool, you know, I guess, novelty, because this is the purest form of gold you will ever find. Nothing is purer, right? And that was kind of like its selling point for many, many years. Now, this is such a cool idea that it was 99.99% gold, like it was pure gold than most gold coins out there, that the U.S. decided to do that as well. Back in 2006, they brought out the American Buffalo. And the American Buffalo is mimicking the Buffalo Nickel design, which is really beautiful. It really is beautiful. But that, in fact, is four nines pure gold as well. So that would be probably the first gold coin, the first ounce gold coin that I do want to get. Of course, I have to have an American Eagle. And all these different coins, they have their kind of pros and cons here and there. Obviously, you want to get the gold from your country. So if you're Canadian, a Canadian maple leaf makes sense, right? You're just representing your people, right? The Canadians. I chose a Canadian maple leaf just because it was the first purest gold coin. I thought it was a beautiful, actual coin is beautiful. I mean, it's hard to show through the plastic because you'll see little scratches and smudges, but that's the actual plastic. It's not the coin. But if I get, let me see how close I can get in here. Okay, blurred out. All right, so that's about as close as I can get, you know, without breaking out the jeweler's loop, which I might do in the future, who knows. But you can see the actual, just the imprinting of the coin, the minting of the coin is perfect. You could see that there's these like, I don't know, there's like a burst. Like imagine from the center, a starburst that goes out, all these lines. You know, they go all the way to the center of the coin, all the way around. I mean, that is a massive detail. It's perfectly done. The actual maple leaf, it looks beautiful. You know what I'm saying? You can see all the detail and the veins of the leaf. And obviously on the front, we have Queen Elizabeth. It's still kicking. Queen Elizabeth II. Now, by the way, this does have a face dollar value of $20 Canadian. And this is 2016. That's the random year they decided to send. So if I wanted to go to Canada on a trip, and I wanted to buy something for $20, I could, in theory, give them this coin. It is legal tender in Canada. That will never happen, clearly. The half-ounce piece here is about the size of a U.S. quarter, okay, for comparison, for size comparison. And obviously, they do make all different sizes. You have the 1 ounce, you have a half-ounce, you have a quarter-ounce, you have a 1/10 ounce, then you have a gram, then you have like a half-gram in some cases of all these different coins. So depending on how much you're willing to spend. But it's important to note that the smaller the coin is, the bigger the premium is. So what that means is that This is a half ounce coin. If I bought 2 half-ounce coins, it would be more expensive than buying 1 1-ounce coin. If you got 4 quarter-ounce, it would cost you more than getting 1 ounce. If you got 10 1/10-ounce coins, it would be the most expensive way to obtain, well, besides buying the grams, right? So the smaller the coin, even though it's cheaper to you, you're paying more of a premium, okay? So just like everything else, it's cheaper when you buy in bulk, the bigger, the cheaper. So yeah, I mean, it's just really, really fascinating, the whole thing. I kind of am getting, specifically with the gold coins, I'm kind of getting into coin collecting. Obviously, my attraction to this is that it's pure gold. This is treasure. You know, when you're like a kid, and you're like, wow, gold. Like, you see it in cartoons, like bars of gold. If I won the lottery, I'd have stacks of bars. Or I'd have coins in a vault, like Scrooge McDuck. I just want to swim in it. It's amazing. There's such an allure there. Human beings have loved shiny stuff for a very long time. Gold and silver specifically. And this truly is treasure. So in that respect, it's so cool. Since I got it, I'm just staring at it. I just stare at it. I just think it's really neat. Just a chunk of gold, real gold in its purest form, minted perfectly into a cool looking coin. So that's what I went with. I do have like a bucket list now of other coins. There's a bunch of like known coins from different countries all around the world. The most recognized gold coin on the planet, I believe, you can correct me if I'm wrong, but I think it's the South African Cougarrand. And that coin has a special meaning to me as well because I love Lethal Weapon. And if you remember the Lethal Weapon movies, the guy, I forget the character's name, Diplomatic Immunity. And then he gets one right between the eyes. You know what I'm talking about. But they were smuggling gold Cougarrand coins because of all the value. I want to say it was drug money, and then they were using the gold and transporting it. That's why they're on the ship, that end scene. Anyway, long story short, that has just kind of a cool thing. It's kind of like when I got into guns, eventually I knew I needed a Beretta 92. I ended up with an M9, which is the military version of the 92, but it's because of Lethal Weapon. It was Mel Gibson's gun. It's just cool, you know? So there's nothing wrong with that, being a big kid and wanting cool stuff. But the Cougarrand is literally the most recognized gold coin on the planet. Number 2 being the American Gold Eagle, okay? And then it goes from there. The Philharmonic coin, again, beautiful coin. There's so many. I'm not going to bore you with them because I don't have them here to show you, but you can Google that. They're just really neat. I just love it. I love everything about it. But the next one on the list, like I said, hopefully is going to be another gold coin, probably the 1 ounce American Buffalo, if I have the patience enough to save up for it. We're looking at close to $2,000. That's a lot of money to buy a coin. And like, you know, I can't just, in my current financial situation and what it's been for years now, I can't just go out and spend $2,000. I can't just take it out of the bank, $2,000, drop it on a coin. Can't do it. What I do is I force save. Like I said, I go to the store, I pretend it's gone. That's it. I take that $5, I put it in a specific spot, and it's gone to me. I don't have it. And as I keep doing that time and time again, whether it's 50 cents in a change jar or $5, you know, somewhere else, that adds up. It takes time. It definitely takes time. But it doesn't matter how much money you have, how much money you make, how much money is accessible to you. You can save. It's going to take a lot longer for some people. Some people can go out and they can afford to spend $20,000 on gold. Oh, I want some gold today. I'm going to buy $20,000 worth of it in an order. And other people might have to wait 5 years to get a gram, you know. It's all relevant to your life and your lifestyle. But it's also priorities, you know. It's not a huge priority for me to collect gold. Obviously, taking care of your bills is the most important. I refuse to be in debt. So if I ever have any small accumulation of debt, I get rid of it. Those are my priorities. But the money I save off to the side, they go into investments. And for me, all my investments, everything, precious metals, stocks, crypto, which I have to say, I got the crypto craze. I love it. It's super high risk and super high reward, and it's proving to be high reward at the moment. But, you know, gold, silver, any kind of savings I do, all these different investments, even knives, I invest in knives. Every now and again, I do buy expensive knives, or I will trade for very expensive knives, and I don't use them. I set them aside as assets. These are my assets. You know, I don't have a bunch of money in the bank, literally. But I do have money here and there in my own banks. And my own version of a bank account accumulates way more interest than any bank can ever offer. And that's why I do this thing, you know. So one day, if there's a serious emergency, it will be very hard to do, but in a serious emergency, I could sell certain things and be able to pay that bill that I need to do, or whatever needs to get done. catastrophic car failure, you know, moving, that's going to be a very big expense. Eventually, I'd like to move. It's just one of those things. I love where I live and everything, and I'm not going to get in a whole separate subject here. But eventually, it's inevitable. I have to find more work. I live in the woods. Minimum wage in Pennsylvania is like $7.25 or $7.50 or something an hour. It's just, it's not going to last forever. You know what I mean? So that's something that's in my future. I want to have children. That's something in my future. If I have a child and I need money for my child, I will absolutely give up all my man toys. I have no problem with that for my child. You know, whether that means daycare or schooling or something they want for Christmas, whatever the case may be. Who knows what the future holds, right? But that's why I do stuff like this. That's why I bought gold. Gold, you know, buying a gold coin for $1,000 is not for rich people. Now, a ton of rich people do that kind of stuff. They invest in gold. They hedge. They use gold as a hedge for other investments. And just hedging just means like a, it's almost like a backup, okay? To explain it in its simplest form. Hey, I'm doing this, but if this fails, I have this that's still good. You know, that's what hedging is. Some people use crypto as a hedge. I don't think that's a great idea, but it's nice to be diverse, okay? You want to diversify your investments. So if one tanks and has a problem, then the other one over here will still stay afloat, you know? But that's why I do this stuff. You don't have to be rich to buy $1,000 worth of gold. You have to be motivated. You have to make that a priority to save, and you have to be patient. That's the most important thing. Anyone watching this can buy this coin. But are you going to be interested enough, long enough to actually save for it? Maybe. Most of you, probably not. But I did. I waited and waited. I just, you kind of forget about this stuff. It's not like every day I'm counting the stack of money and thinking, oh, can I get that coin yet? It's not like that. You just kind of forget about it. I really do pretend. I'm able to pretend that money no longer exists. And if I need it, it's not accessible. I just don't do it. I can't do that. And even if you're not even talking about investments, if you're just talking about saving money in general, paying bills, you know, if you got a little extra money, like everyone got this the stimulus money, which by the way, not that it matters, but I didn't get stimulus 2, I didn't get stimulus 3, I'm not going to. My wife didn't get stimulus 2 or stimulus 3, she's not going to. Why? Because the IRS didn't get around to doing our taxes yet. Whose fault is that? The IRS. Now, when I don't pay my taxes on time, they give me a big penalty. Shouldn't they pay me a penalty since they didn't get mine done on time? But that's not how it works, unfortunately. Mini rant over as far as the stimulus goes. But like a stimulus is a great example of a bunch of people got a bunch of money they weren't expecting. How you use that, it really, I mean, it depends on the person. Some people bought gold. Some people bought a big old TV. Some people ate out a bunch of times. You know what I'm saying? People spend their money any way they want. That's your prerogative. But it's just, it comes down to priorities. You know what I mean? So as a hobby, saving money is a hobby to me, and it makes me feel really good. When I lay down at night, my head's on the pillow, and I'm staring at the ceiling trying to fall asleep, I just feel good knowing that if something bad happens, something really bad happened, I have a plan B. That's what it's all for. And if nothing else, if I live the rest of my life and I don't need that money, it just all goes to my child one day. That's all it is. It just slowly collects and collects and collects. Maybe it'll be for retirement. Anyway, I'm starting to ramble about all kinds of stuff that's not related to gold, so I'm going to stop there. I'm just going to say that I am extremely happy with this and very much looking forward to future gold purchases. Silver is on the back burner for now. Gold is where it's at. If you have gold and you want knives, hit me up because I want gold and I have knives. So we can definitely work something out. You know what I'm saying? Hit me up on Instagram. But I got the gold bug right now, hardcore. And I'm looking at all kinds of gold, but I'm out. I'm tapped out. I spent my grand or close to $1,000, and I'm good for a while for the gold kick. But yeah, you have to buy it. You have to be in it to win it, right? So the only way to accumulate is to save up, buy it, sit on it, buy more, save more, buy more, and then eventually you got a collection of gold. But the coolest part about it is I could sell it at any time, and it's still going to have value no matter what. Is it going to have as much value? Maybe. Price might go down. It might go up. Maybe it's worth more next year. That's the game. So anyway, that's all. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you have an awesome day. Let me know down in the comment section. You don't have to be specific for privacy reasons, but let me know, do you collect silver? Do you collect gold? And do you collect both? I'm just curious. Now I collect both, seriously. So hope you guys have a fantastic day, and I'll see you tomorrow with a brand new video. Take care.